Well, good morning, everyone. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with a look at the Canadian stock market for Wednesday morning. Let's start off in New York, and stock index futures are down below fair value. It's not that bad at the moment. S&P 500 futures down just 3 points. Crude oil is also lower in the pre-market, while gold is unchanged. So I wouldn't be surprised to see some selling at 9:30 Wednesday morning. Now, the VIX is still on a buy signal, had an inside day yesterday, so that is negative for stocks. Monday was a bearish reversal day in the U.S., and we saw fall through to the downside yesterday, so there is a high potential that we put in a top on Monday. That, of course, would be confirmed with a close below the lower channel line, which on Wednesday for the S&P 500 cash index is 2608.93. A close below that point would give us a new daily sell signal. Now, the market is still being hit hard by selling in the technology sector, which made a new low yesterday. Saw a little buying in the chip sector coming into the close, but still made a new low for this move on Tuesday, and certainly did not take out the previous day's high. Moving on, looking at the Canadian market, there's nothing bullish to see here. The TSX started to break down below last week's low. If we start breaking down below 15,900, then the November low is not too far away. And if we take that out, that will paint a very bearish picture. If we look at stocks by market cap, you can see it's the big cap stocks still holding us up. Once you move away from those big cap stocks, and you start looking at mid caps, for example, you can see we put in a lower high here in November, and now we're starting to break down and getting very close to the November low. For small cap stocks, we're not haven't sold off that much, but it's even more bearish picture. We put in a lower high there and then another lower high last week, so that's very bearish. And then the Venture Exchange has been on a sell signal for a while now. No change in trend there. Looking at sectors, energy stocks have traded in the channel and hit the lower channel line for the past 2 days. And so with crude oil down in the pre-market this morning, we'll probably generate a new sell signal on Wednesday. Looking at the banking stocks, they're still on a buy signal. If we look at financial services, we closed just below the lower channel line yesterday, so we're back on a sell signal there. Gold stocks continued to move lower yesterday. We're looking at healthcare stocks still on a buy signal, industrials still on a buy signal, and then there's Infotech, which made a new low yesterday. The new low is below the November low, so that's very bearish. Yes, just like in the U.S., we saw a little buying going into the close, but certainly not enough to change the overall direction. There's global mining stocks taking out the November low yesterday, and we'll see the big move down in copper in a minute. Real estate stocks still on a sell signal, no change in trend for telecom, and no change in trend for utility stocks. Looking at the cannabis stocks, or the weed stocks as I call them, there's a new high for Alphria. Fairly quiet trading yesterday for Aurora and Canopy Growth, which traded up to the upper channel line once again. Let's finish off today's presentation looking at commodity prices. Starting in the energy sector, crude oil traded into the channel yesterday. A close below 56.89 would give us a sell signal on Wednesday, and that is certainly possible. Natural gas was down hard yesterday, back on a sell signal. Now, this chart looks pretty spastic. I had the talk yesterday in the U.S. presentation, but there's a big, huge difference between trading natural gas and trading crude oil. If we look at the average true range for crude oil at the moment, it's just a little over 2% per day. That's the difference between the high and the low of crude oil. If we look at natural gas, and natural gas is in an extremely quiet period right now. The flypaper channel is basically flat, but still natural gas, the average true range is a little over 4%. And what I try to explain to people is trading natural gas is like trading a hand grenade in which you've pulled the pin. It is extremely volatile. And so if you're thinking of trading futures, trading crude oil is one thing. Trading natural gas is an extreme. And again, natural gas is still incredibly volatile, even though it's in a very quiet period. And you can see that we've got all the moving averages converging. The 200-day moving average is basically flat across the screen. Nothing's trending here, but still, natural gas is extremely volatile. Looking at copper was down a huge amount yesterday. And so for those people around the world who view copper as a global economic barometer, that's not a good sign for the global economy going forward. And there's gold down again yesterday, making a new low for this move, as did the price of silver head sharply lower on Tuesday. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. I'm going to be back on Thursday morning looking at the the TSX most actively traded stocks, and then I'll be back on Friday to look at the U.S. most actively traded stocks. Have a great day, folks, and I'll talk to you again soon.